スタンド使い。
ああ。
スタンド使い。
ああ、いかんぞ司会。
スタンド使い。
TikTok famous, what I'm gon' do. Stack up all my pandas and buy stuff I can't afford to. Live in the classroom, join me if you want to. Think I'm gonna do my little dance like so.
White J's, white Porsche, white wrist, white horse, high bitch, high bitch, high bitch, high bitch. I do not sniff it to roll it.
I drew a star. Plus his daughter. The baby star listens as he reads the wishes that humans made on him.
Tips for using colored pencils. If you notice your drawing's a little dull at an angle, that's called wax blooming, and you can wipe it off with a tissue. Your hands' oils can smudge the colored pencils, so use a foofy makeup brush to wipe away wax shavings instead. Instead of finding the perfect shade, mix colors. Always color in a circular motion to avoid streakiness. Always go lighter at the beginning and darker at the end because layering is really important. Using a marker base saves a lot of time, and make sure your pencils are sharp.
Take a photo of a plate and a pair of chopsticks and upload it to iPhone Notes. With the darkest shade of green, draw a cylinder shape and go around the chopstick just like so. Then we use white pencil tool to coloring in the rice. Next, we use an orangey red to join the salmon and green for the avocado. Then we just add some small details on the avocado and the salmon as well. Next, with gray and the thinnest brush head, we draw the tiniest lines to show the little grains of rice. After, we go over the seaweed once again with a layer of black. Then we use the selective pen tool to copy and paste the sushi. Don't forget to fill in the gaps and copy once again and paste it as many times as you wish. Lastly, draw some shadows and voila.
So I saw this game where you have to try to connect the dots and make a little rectangle using the whirlpool effect. Let's see how I do. I just turned the effect on. Look at this. Oh my god, this is gonna be hard. What the hell? And we're starting. Okay. No. I got that one. Let's move down. It's just a straight line. It's all in your head. It's all in your head. Let's go to the side. Okay. You got this. Where's the other dot? You'll stop moving. Oh! That might have been nice. Let's go up. Just move up. No, why are you turning backwards? No. Okay, I got it. Let's go up here. Oh, Jesus. Okay, across. It's just a straight line. Boom. Okay, let's turn off the effect. Oh my god. The fuck?
Sheets, puzzles, and darts, and baking. Paper mache, a bit of ballet and chess. Pottery and ventriloquy candle making. Then I'll stretch, maybe sketch, take a climb. Sew a dress, and I'll regrade the books if I have time to spare. Paint the wall some more, I'm sure there's room. So
let the rain pour, I'll be all you need and more.
When I told my family I was going to open my own business doing sculptures, they all thought I was insane. When I said I'd quit my full-time job to pursue this, they thought I was crazy. They kept telling me, "Girl, you've never even worked with clay before. How do you know that you're going to be any good?" And I was like, "You just watch me." Because I'm good at anything I put my mind to. I am successful in every part of my life. Why would this be any different? So what? I had to take out a second mortgage on my house to turn my garage into an art studio. They said, "Why don't you just practice for a little bit before you quit your job and do all of that? Make sure it's something that you really like." And I was like, "Guys, I've got this. Please, I've got this. You don't even know." So to all the haters out there who didn't believe in me, I say, get out of my swamp.
repeat, I'm the king of the rumba beat. When I play the maracas, I go chick, chicky, boom, chick, chicky, boom. Yes, sir, I'm Cuban feet. I'm the craze, I'm on a death street. When I start to dance, everything goes chick, chicky, boom, chick, chicky, boom. The senoritas, they sing and they swing with their rompero. It's very nice, so full of spice. And when they're dancing, they bring a happy ring that I can't.
A few weeks ago, I bought some expired film on eBay for about $10. This pack expired in 2005, and knowing that I wasn't guaranteed any images, I loaded it up into my camera and decided to have some fun with this first roll. When shooting with expired film, you have to compensate for light sensitivity loss, so while shooting this entire roll, I was shooting a stop and a half overexposed, which all that means is I was letting in more light to the film so it could be exposed properly, because over time, the chemistry within the film starts to break down, so to make your images, you need more light to actually make an impression on the film. I've shot expired rolls of film in the past that have just turned out blank, so you might be wondering, why would you even shoot expired film? And my answer is, it's cheap, it's fun, and it looks cool. The photos usually come out with weird colors, a lot of grain, and many different imperfections that are great for experimentation, so I recommend you pick up a roll and have some fun. Thanks for watching.
You so, hey, that's what you'll say. You'll tell me, baby, baby, please don't go away.
Don't go away.
But when I play, I never stay.
I never